हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट ह्यूमिडिफिकेशन प्रोसेस। ह्यूमिडिफिकेशन, सो ह्यूमिडिफिकेशन इज ए टाइप ऑफ एयर कंडीशनिंग प्रोसेस इन विच द एडिशन और इंजेक्शन ऑफ वाटर टू द एयर। सो ड्यूरिंग ह्यूमिडिफिकेशन प्रोसेस द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द एयर रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट। So humidification, it is defined as addition or supply or injection of water vapor to the air, water vapor, or it you can use other word moisture to the air. So during process, during the process, the temperature of air remains constant. So this is the definition of the humidification, and it is a one type of air conditioning process. So to understand the definition, we'll consider one small sketch. I will draw one small sketch and I will explain you the humidification process. So consider one pipe. Here air is flowing. So point number one is inlet. Here is air. Temperature of the air at point number one is T1. So obviously it is a dry bulb temperature, and the moisture content or water vapor content at point number one inside the air is omega 1. So omega represents moisture content or water vapor, and the relative humidity at point number one is 5:1, because 30% of water may be there, 40% of water will be there. Understood? There is no meaning that the water content is zero. It has some amount of water content, that is omega 1, and the relative humidity is 5:1. Now this air is unsaturated. This is unsaturated air. So to unsaturated air to convert into saturated, we need water. So you have to mix some water to the unsaturated air, and this is a thirsty air. So when unsaturated air mix with the water or absorbs water, it will become saturated. So to mix water to this saturated air, I will consider one humidifier. Here is a humidifier. So to humidifier, I will supply the water. So when you supply water inside the humidifier, you will spray water or inject water to the air. Here also I am injecting water to the air. So this unsaturated air absorb water and mix with water, it will become saturated at point number 2. So at point number 2, it will become saturated air. Now the water content at point number 2 is omega 2. Moisture content at point number 2 is omega 2. And the temperature of the air at point number 2 is T2. That is a dry bulb temperature. And the relative humidity is 5:2. These are the conditions at point number 2. Now during the process, as I said, humidification is injection of water. Here we have supplied water, and this water mix with the air, unsaturated air, and it will become saturated. Now this condition, this process, and these properties will represent on psychrometric chart. So this is a psychrometric chart. Here we'll consider one psychrometric chart. This is the layout of the psychrometric chart. So here the horizontal line, that is a dry bulb temperature, and the vertical line is the moisture content, that is omega, or it is also called water vapor in 1 kg of air. On the y-axis, amount of water vapor in 1 kg of air, it is omega, or it is also called as specific humidity. On the y-axis, specific humidity, or it is also called humidity ratio. All are same. Okay, so y-axis humidity ratio, or specific humidity, or water content or moisture content. Now at point number 1, what is the temperature? Here it is T1. So somewhere here I will take T1 is the temperature at point number 1. T1. And during the process 1 to 2, the moisture content is increased, because as the definition said, addition or supply of water vapor or moisture content. So moisture content is increased, that is omega 2 at point number 2 will be more than omega at point number 1. So here the moisture omega is 1 at point number 1, some percent, 0.016 value or 0.02 value, some amount of water vapor in the air. The omega value at point number 2 is increasing, and it is more than 0.1. So I will draw one vertical line. This is the point, new point, point number 2. This is omega 2 value. So omega value is increasing, and during the process 1 to 2, the temperature is constant. That is T1 should be equal to T2. That is the reason you have written, during the process, the temperature of air remains constant. So this is the concept of humidification. So conclusion is, during the humidification, temperature at point number 1, that is a dry bulb temperature at point number 1 is equal to at point number 2, and during humidification the moisture content is increased, the omega at outlet is more than the omega value at inlet, and relative humidity also increases. Omega at point number 2 is more than, that is 5, relative humidity at point number 1. So here it is 5 value, 5.1, and here it is 5.2, that is relative humidity at point number 2. Here it is 30% of relative humidity. By supply of water, this water mix with air and increase in percentage of water, so relative humidity increases. So this is the concept of humidification, and here is a representation on psychrometric chart. So next topic we will consider the dehumidification process. Dehumidification, the definition is, it is exactly opposite to the humidification process. It is humidification, and here it is dehumidification. So now we will define the definition. It is also one type of air conditioning process. It is also one type of air conditioning process. Here, dehumidification defined as removal of water vapor or moisture content from air. But condition is, during the process, again the temperature remains same. During the process, temperature of air remains constant. Temperature of the air remains constant. So now, to understand humidification, again I will consider one small sketch here. Here is a pipe. Here we are supplying air. this is point number one. So point number one is a inlet condition of the air, and the dry bulb temperature at point number one is TB1, and the moisture content at point number one is omega 1. Here the moisture content is more. You need to remove the moisture content. That is called dehumidification, removal of water vapor or moisture content from the air. Initially the air has more water vapor. You need to remove the water vapor, so that process is called dehumidification. The condition is, during the dehumidification, the temperature of the air should be constant. Now the relative humidity at point number one is 5.1, and now to remove the water vapor, one point you need to remember here: the water vapor which is presented in the air should get condensed into liquid. So I will use one evaporating coil, just like an evaporating coil. When this air touches the surface of this coil, and the temperature of the air, that is dry bulb temperature of the air, when it becomes less than the dew point temperature of the air, then the water content in the air, that is water vapor or moisture content in the air, start condense to liquid, and those liquid will be collected outside here and it will be removed later. Understood? So when the condensation of the water vapor takes place here, here is a water vapor inside the air. So this water vapor from the air starts condensing to liquid when the condition is the temperature of the air become less than dew point temperature. So at point number two, the water content is less in the air, because all water vapor is condensed to liquid. So when the air coming outside at point number two here, the water vapor is less. So omega 2 is less than omega 1. The water content at point number 2 in the air is less than the water content in the air at point number 1. But during the process, the temperature should be constant. Dry bulb temperature at point number 1 should be equals to dry bulb temperature at point number 2. At the same time, the relative humidity is decreases. The 5.1 will be more and 5.2 will be less. So here now these three properties will represent on psychrometric chart. I'll consider on psychrometric chart. On the x-axis it is a dry bulb temperature, and the y-axis is water vapor or moisture content in kg per kg of air. What does it mean is amount of water vapor in 1 kg of air. That will be replaced. That property is called omega. Omega value, that is moisture content, or it is also called specific humidity, SH, or it is also called humidity ratio. Okay, now at point number 1, the moisture content is more. Omega 1 value is more. So I will represent omega 1 here somewhere here. This is point number 1. Omega. So air has more water content at point number 1. So during the process, when the air releases all water vapor and starts condensing liquid, so at point number 2, the water content of the air is less. So it is the process. So here is the point number 2. So during the process, again the temperature remains constant. Here dry bulb temperature is same here. So dry bulb temperature at point number 1 is equal to dry bulb temperature at point number 2. So this is how the humidification and dehumidification process will be represented on psychrometric chart. This dehumidification process you might have seen practically in leakage of water in auditorium or AC room. You might have seen some droplet of water will be falling down from the floor, from the terrace and all. So that is dehumidification. Or you might have seen in the early morning, 3 a.m. or 4 a.m. when you go outside for walking, some drops of water on the grass surfaces. So that is all effect of dehumidification process. So in the dehumidification, you need to remember one point: the temperature of the air will become less than dry bulb temperature will become less than dew point temperature. So when the air achieve this condition, then the moisture content of the air will starts condensing to liquid, and the liquid water will be taken out later. So this phenomenon will takes place in air conditioning. So one point you need to remember again, note related to humidification and dehumidification. Here humidification and dehumidification process are very difficult to carry out practically. The reason is, here in the humidification you might have seen here, so this unsaturated air when mixed with the water, so assume that the temperature of the water, obviously it will not be equal to temperature of the air. The temperature of the water will be more than the temperature of the air. So when water has high temperature, this high temperature water mixes with the cold air, there is a heat transfer between water to air. The temperature of the air increases slowly and it becomes 2. But during this process, the temperature will not be remains constant. So temperature of the air increases. So humidification is not possible practically because of this reason. Simultaneously, same process here in the dehumidification also. The temperature of the air to maintain same is very difficult. Here, when the water is releasing, or the air is releasing its water vapor to outside, the temperature of the air decreases. So due to decrease in temperature, the temperature at point number 2 will become less. So will not be remain same at point number 1. So both point number 1 temperature will not be same as point number 2. So dehumidification is also not possible practically, just like humidification process. I will explain once again clearly here. Humidification and dehumidification, humidification and dehumidification process are not possible to conduct practically. The reason is, when the temperature of the air what you are supplying to increase the water content of the air, here the temperature of the water is more than the air temperature. When there is a difference in temperature, the high temperature fluid release heat to low temperature fluid. Here the water absorb heat and the temperature of the water here increases. Here the temperature of the air increases, and that high temperature air, it will come outside as a saturated air. So T2 will become more than T1, practical case. But during humidification, what is the condition? The temperature should be same. So this is not possible practically. So this humidification and dehumidification will be accompanied with either heating process or cooling process. In the previous video lecture, we discussed that heating and humidification process, or it is also called in another way, cooling and dehumidification process. Instead of calling separately humidification, so this humidification process will be accompanied with either heating or cooling. That is one air conditioning process. For example, when you are accompanied this humidification with heating process, we will call it as heating and humidification air conditioning process. When this humidification you are accompanying with cooling, then will become cooling and humidification air conditioning process. Similarly, when this dehumidification process, when you are accompanying with cooling and dehumidification air conditioning process. Similarly, heating and dehumidification air conditioning process. So in the next lecture we will discuss the cooling and dehumidification process, and at the same time cooling and humidification process. So thank you so much for watching this video. So if you want to understand the properties of psychrometry, here is the link provided. Click on this link on the top right corner, and you can understand the concepts of psychrometric properties. Thank you so much for watching this video. Bye bye. Take care.